that star-spangled banner yet wave, or the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Oh, a fantastic rendition of the national anthem. Back with more right after this. And welcome to 2K Sports for another edition of NBA Basketball. With Grant Hill and Steve Smith, I'm Brian Anderson. Allie LaForce is our reporter. Allie, take it away.
Michael Jordan, the Hornets team owner, said 5 years ago he probably could still beat most of his players one-on-one. But he added, "I don't want to demolish their confidence, so I stay away. Let them think they're good." In fact, at age 50, he did beat a rookie one-on-one, but now approaching 60, guys, maybe he's finally over the hill, although you can never root against Jordan.
Oh, you never know. Allie, good stuff. Thank you. All right, let's look at the last handful of seasons and the steals numbers for Paul George.
And when you see the decline his steal totals have taken the last few years, you can see that he's not playing that type of gritty, intense D that he's used to. That's a part of his game he needs to bring back.
Now the opening lineup for the Los Angeles Clippers. On the wings, it's George and Kawhi. Morris and Zubats play together in the front court. And it's Jackson in at the point. And for the Hornets, P.J. Washington out there with McDaniels. Then it's Ball. Then it's Terry Rozier. And it's Martin in at the three. And deep into the season now, Grant, are you noticing any trends that may just become a permanent part of the game?
Well, B.A., there's a few trends that are obvious. One, the use of rest and load management. I think that's here to stay for a while. Also, in terms of the game and style and moves, the Euro step, obviously, which was, you know, a few years ago, but the step-back three-pointer. No one shot a step-back three-pointer 30 years ago. Everyone does now. Everyone has that in their playbook. So those are just a few things that I think will be around for a while.
Kicks it out to Jackson. Counted from distance.
You know, a little inconsistent from deep when he first entered the league. Jackson now an emerging three-point threat.
Rozier outside. Driving in. Takes a 13-footer. Connects. The jumper drops.
Easy look when the defender isn't fighting over the screen.
Reason why it takes extra energy to do it. You have to trust your defensive rotations, but it's worth it.
Pass to George. Leonard outside. And here's Zubats. Clock at 6. To the paint. Here's Morris. McDaniels with the rebound. Here are the Hornets with the ball. The last time they came together was in Los Angeles, where they fell to the Clippers.
And it was an awful game defensively. They lost the individual matchups, and the help was slow to rotate.
Point blank, this is a bad combination. If you're looking to get stops, that's not the way.
Alley-oop up top, hammer it home.
I like when Reggie Jackson is seeking out his teammates. He could have took that shot, but his teammate, he was wide open.
Pass to Rozier. The three ball fires in the triple. Rozier's got 5 points.
I love this approach. Getting him involved early, and it's already paying off.
It makes sense, right? You're trying to get off to a fast start, and he can help with that.
Leonard. The Hornets pull it in.
He is so good attacking the rim. It's rare to see him denied like that.
Pass to McDaniels. And he got the whistle on the way up, so he'll be headed to the line for a pair. That one on Morris.
And even from where we're sitting, you could clearly tell it was a foul.
Shooting two.
And the free throw is good. Now leading by one. And so he hits both. Los Angeles has gone 1-for-2 from beyond the arc in this first quarter. George passes to Leonard. That one falls. He's now 1-for-3.
Aggressive D there, but then again, Kawhi finishes through contact almost as well as anyone.
Kawhi Leonard, a two-time Defensive Player of the Year, has all the tools, and we know he's dedicated on that end. Does an excellent job of scouting out his opponents and taking away their first and second options. And you look at teams, they try to go away from Kawhi when he's on that end.
Now here's Jackson. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against New York. Pass to Zubats. George outside. Shoots over Rozier. And again, it's the Clippers converting. Smitty, you get a sense. A lot of players don't like playing against Kawhi Leonard.
Because the question, B.A., is why. He is stifling. He denies touches, swallows up your airspace, and despite his aggressiveness, he's rarely baited into fouls.
Count that bucket.
And setting the tempo with an assertive move. Like, where was the defense on that play?
No excuse. You have to be aware. He should be on your radar all the time.
Now here's Leonard. We saw him with 29 points in his last game.
Right there, that is poise of Kawhi Leonard, just taking what the defense gives him.
Out to the right wing. Just over 3.5 minutes gone here in the first. And Rozier, here we go. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Rozier's got 7 points.
This is why you're trying to get him as many touches as possible. He's got the neck.
Stolen by Rozier. Here's Washington. Rejected by George.
Not going to be Paul George with that move. He's too long and too talented of a defender.
Pass to Martin. Here's Rozier. Ball with it. Rozier outside. Just 5 to shoot. Now here's Washington. Shoots over George.
I love the way George can move his feet and challenge the shot without fouling.
Now Zubats. Back to Jackson. George outside from behind the arc. And no good. And it's the Hornets taking it the other way. They're moving on after the tough loss at the hands of the Pelicans.
They failed to create enough good looks. The ball movement just wasn't quite where it needed to be.
You know, they take one step forward, two steps back, and exercise in frustration.
Now here's George. He had an 18-point outing in their last game against New York.
And it wasn't just the scoring. He also impacted the game on the glass. Terrific all-around effort.
They keep capturing the lead, then giving it back. We'll see if they can hold on to it this time.
Both teams putting forth their best efforts right now. This is the kind of game fans pay to see.
They have no answer defensively inside.
Here's Leonard, a proven scorer in this league, averaging just over 25 a game.
And he probably thought he was going to bury that one.
Pass to McDaniels. Back to Ball. This one for 3. It's rebounded by Zubats.
Given his range, you'd expect him to capitalize on that opening.
Out of bounds. It'll go to the Hornets. Late into the season, let's check out the standings in the West. You look at the Clippers. Right now, they rank 3rd in the conference, aiming for a high seed in the postseason.
When I look at the Clippers, give them credit. I mean, they've been playing very well this season, but they can't afford to take their foot off the gas pedal right now. They know they have a bullseye on their backs.
Right. They knew teams would be gunning for them night in and night out. That's only fueled their commitment to putting a great product on the floor.
Here's Martin, currently averaging 5 points a game. Charlotte again missing. George against Rozier. George, good. George has got 7 points in the game.
Excellent concentration from Paul George, overwhelming the aggressive defense with his strength and determination.
Here's Graham. George with the block. Outside, Rondo. Pass to Leonard. Over Washington. Leonard can't get it to go.
And the truth is, this league would have been much bigger had he shot better.
To the left wing. Tipped away. Out to the wing. Outside Graham. Shoots over George. George with the block. Pass to Zubats. And Devontae Graham is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul of the game. Charlotte making some changes. Biombo, he's checked in for Washington. And it's Monk in for Rozier. And I'm glad we got to see the mobile one block once more. What a play.
And just incredible timing and defensive awareness. I mean, when you face a defender that can reject you like this, it can alter your entire approach.
Hornets on D. They trail by one. Here's Martin. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. There's the drive. Inside. And he was camped in the lane there. He gets a 3-second call. The Clippers have gone 7 of 14 and looking in control. Beverly outside. Pass to Cousins. Up and over Biombo. Ooh, good work defensively by Biombo. The Hornets have got half their attempts to go. 6 of 12. Now Graham. Pass to Zeller. Clock at 4. To end the drought. Gets the 3 to fall. And the Hornets lead by 2. And the chess match continues.
7 lead changes already, and we're still in the first half.
Ooh, good work defensively by Biombo.
Out of character for him to miss that shot. Maybe just a little too casual there.
A 1:06 left to play in the first. Now Graham. Boy, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Can't hit from the elbow.
High percentage look for him. But bottom line, they're not all going to go down.
The 3 is up. And the rebound goes to the Hornets. There's 38 seconds left to play in the first quarter. And the foul on Patrick Beverly. That's his first foul of the game.
That's something you hate. You're trying to come in with an aggressive mindset, and that early foul could take you right out of it.
And the Clippers making a change here. Oh. 32 seconds left in the first. Here's Biombo. It doesn't go for him. Good work defensively by Cousins. Beverly outside. There's 14 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. 6 on the shot clock to the inside. It's deflected. One quarter in the books, and it's been a close one. Hornets out in front, up 2. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break. And recently, we spoke with Patrick Beverley about his throwback style.
Old school basketball. You know, and it's fun, and it's light. Fans deserve it on both sides. It's good old-fashioned basketball. You know, it's all a part of the game. We're both trying to win, and that's what people want to see. Hard-nosed, edgy basketball.
Man, pound for pound, Beverley may be the most physical player in the league.
And he also gets in your head. It's a combination that allows him to get stops against guys as big as Kevin Durant.
And close game underway so far. We'll see if either of these teams can jump out ahead in the second quarter. And from what we've seen from the Hornets, what's your take so far?
Well, there's no reason to take risky shots when you can collect points at the rim.
Especially at the start. You want to get something positive going and establish your rhythm.
Malik Monk is out there with Ball. Then there's Cody Zeller. Then it's Bismack Biyombo. And it's Martin in at the three slot. That's the Hornets five.
And yeah, that old adage about being too wide open, not a thing. He just missed it.
Beverly shot off. The Hornets with a lead. You know, Grant, Pat Beverly said he's trying to be the best defender on the planet. And the way he competes, I believe him.
I believe it too. I mean, this young man from Chicago spent 5 years fighting and scrapping overseas. Defense became his meal ticket. But even in the NBA, he's never lost that chip on his shoulder.
Here's Cousins. Oh, that doesn't go on the chance to tie. For Charlotte, they've got none of their first three shots to fall so far in the second. We're about a minute and a half into the second quarter now. Pass to Zeller. Here's Monk. From the arc. Buries it from three. And the Hornets lead by five.
Defensively, you have to tighten up on him or suffer the consequences. All this means is he has to be careful. Don't want to pick up a cheapie and get sent to the bench with three fouls.
Both teams will make substitutions. Beverly against Ball. To the middle. Here's Cousins. And he can't get that one. Ooh, Washington with the defensive effort. Pass to Martin. Over to the wing. Now Washington. Checked by Cousins. Shot clock at six. Here's McDaniels. Over Morris. McDaniels can't hit. And here in the second quarter of action, just a hair under 2.5 minutes played. Now here's Ball. Pass to McDaniels. Now here's Washington. Checked by Cousins. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Getting enough shots in close to play inside out.
Well, Grant, we're seeing more and more teams fall in love with the three ball right now. You think there's anything the league could do to promote more balance offensively?
Well, that is a concern because we've gotten a little bit out of balance with everyone shooting too many three-point shots.
One shot.
I had a couple of ideas, like one of them might be to eliminate the three-point shot from the corner. And now that's a two-point shot. And so it would change the schemes defensively, the spacing, might require more ball movement and player movement on the offensive end. A lot of guys now use the three-point line from a spacing standpoint. But it's interesting. Unless there's some rule changes, I don't know if you can really change where this game is at right now.
Now here's Ball. They lead by eight. Biggest lead of the game. Pass to Washington. Back to Rozier. Here's Ball. Off target. That would have pushed the lead to double digits. For Los Angeles, they've gone 0 for 6 in the second. Not looking good. Here's Leonard. Hounded by Ball. The floater. And count the basket. He was fouled, and he's going to the line for one more.
Kawhi Leonard, the 2019 Finals MVP. He clearly had the doubters and critics on his mind as he celebrated, as we heard from the inscription he had inside his title ring.
Smithy, you talk about Kawhi's critics. You know, after he left the Spurs, Coach Greg Popovich said he hadn't been much of a leader there. How about his leadership now?
Well, B.A., not a rah-rah guy or a towel waver. He leads by example. The way he works, competes at both ends, and wins. So to me, that answers the question of leadership.
Now here's Ball. Again, the miss by the Hornets. Rondo with it. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Here's Leonard. And that one hits the back iron. Charlotte has gone 1 of 2 from downtown here in the second. Washington outside. Back to Ball. Here's Martin. George defending. And he drives in. Got a hand on it. And they'll keep possession. The Clippers trail. Pass to Zubats. And here's George. That's good. For the day, he's 4 for 6.
So smart with the ball in his hands. George reads the floor well and takes advantage of what's there.
Here's McDaniels. Looking at the numbers, he's putting up 7 points a game. Here's Ball. It's rebounded by Zubats. Zubats has got rebound number 8 here already in the game. George outside. Charlotte has gotten 3 of their 7 threes to find the net in this matchup. Pass to Martin. Fires the 3. Unable to get that one. And the Clippers will go the other way with it. Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to the Knicks.
Yeah, they know they should have played better in that one. Not quite sure what happened.
You know, sometimes you don't play up to your full potential. The important thing to figure out is what went wrong. In a funk this quarter, he's trying to shoot his way out of it.
Rozier with it. To stop the drought. Drills it from deep. Rozier's got 10 points in the game.
So reliable. They've really leaned on him at the offensive end.
Trying to find a spark here.
Yes, indeed. A rough stretch offensively. They could really use a basket.
Zubac, screen. Here's George. And there's the rejection. Out of bounds. The Clippers will keep possession. Both teams deciding to change it up. Here's Leonard. Defense is right there.
He's kind of lost his way this period, having a hard time getting anything to go down.
George against Rozier. Down to 5 on the shot clock. 3-pointer off the mark. Well, Los Angeles shooting only 29% in this one. Not great. And he lobs it up top. And the lob disrupted. Not to be. Ball outside. Pass to Rozier. Down low. And it goes out of bounds. That one's off Rozier. Let's see some of the numbers here for Kawhi Leonard.
And he's had a rough past 5 games. He's had trouble finding his offensive rhythm and just hasn't been as effective as he'd like to be on that end. But this is something all players go through, and I'm sure he'll fight his way back.
And here's Jackson, right now contributing around 10.5 points a game. Back to Zubats. Goes up from the block. Yep, that one goes. Zubats has gotten his first points in this one. Charlotte has gone 2 of 5 from deep here in the second. Here's Monk. An important role in this offense, averaging around 12.5 per game. Graham for three. The Clippers grab the miss. Zubats has got 9 rebounds now. Kennard with it. Biombo's there. Pass to Leonard. There's Jackson with the three. Zeller with the rebound. The Hornets with the lead. Now Graham. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. He's off on that one. Ooh, excellent D there from Jackson. All right, let's check in with Ali LaForce.
Well, the Hornets are going young. Coach James Borrego said, quote, "The way we're building this is to compete. It's important for our guys to understand that it starts on the defensive end for us. We are turning the corner. I think a lot of it has to do with the length and athleticism we have on the floor." Brian?
Yeah, I'd agree with that. Thanks, Ali.
Can you believe it? He's missed every shot he's taken, yet this team still continues to hold the lead.
Here's Kennard. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up.
Trying to defend Kennard. You know he can hit shots with limited space. That helps him get you off balance.
Knocks down the first one.
You know, there's always going to be room in this league for guys like Luke Kennard. He can shoot, he can pass it, and he can put it on the floor.
That one falls, so he hits both of them. Here's Monk. .114 left in the first half of this one. Six to shoot. On the take. Here's Zeller. And that one's good with extra effort on the glass.
This has been a close game in a lot of ways, but they do have an edge on the boards.
Pass to Cousins. 50 seconds left to play in the first half. Kennard outside. Lets it go from deep. Yes, and a nice assist from Jackson. Jackson's got 3 assists tonight.
When Kennard is that set up, he almost can't miss. Such a skilled shooter.
Now here's Zeller. 17 points for him last game against New Orleans.
And it wasn't just the points. He brought hustle. He brought energy. And he brought it on the glass. Coming off a scoreless first quarter, he's found a little rhythm here.
2-second difference between shot and game clock. Jackson outside. Inside. The fadeaway. And too long on the shot. And the first half comes to a conclusion in a game that's been very close so far. Hornets out in front, up by 4. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and the Jet, Kenny Smith. Let's get to it. And for a team that's never made the conference final, Shaq, it's no wonder the Hornets have also never had a regular season MVP.
Kemba Walker, Larry Johnson, Alonzo Mourning, Dale Curry, great former Hornets who never had that one magical year.
Muggsy Bogues,
Kendall Gill.
Glenn Rice.
But lately, the talent cupboard has been bare.
The low attendance numbers reflect the lack of stars on the roster. But I think MJ and the rest of that team and that organization will get it better.
And that wraps up the halftime show. Third quarter is set to begin in just a few.
We've got second half action for you, and if the next couple of quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. You know, one of the stories here, Terry Rozier. Man, is he getting it done today.
The numbers say it all. He spent the first half playing efficient ball.
And it's not like everything's been at the rim. There's been a number of jump shots along the way.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been a fairly even one. On the floor for the Clippers, Kawhi and Morris in at the forward slots. Paul George out there with Reggie Jackson. And it's Zubats in at the five, roaming the paint. Out to the right wing. Now here's Rozier. He's guarded by Zubats. It's tipped. Pass to Leonard. What a terrific move that is. Leonard's got nine.
Great job by Kawhi. Strong, physical, plays with an edge.
Washington up top. Shoots over Zubats. And it's Washington missing.
Both sides attacking. That was good defense versus good offense.
This for the tie! And George lays it in. He's got 11.
With his great length and skill, Paul George has no trouble getting points in the paint.
Pass to McDaniels.
That's just being out of sync and at the worst time, costly.
And just a great job of getting there first and absorbing the contact.
And a chance there to look back at the stunning mobile one block a moment ago.
Impressive. I mean, you can see the mindset he has. When the game is this close, he really brings it at that end of the floor.
Now the Clippers with it. They haven't given up any points here in the second half. George against Rozier. Oh, no good. Had a chance to take the lead. 90 seconds into the second half now. Pass to McDaniels. Here's the three. Drains the triple. And the Hornets lead by three.
This is the shot you want to get him. An open look from range.
Here's George. And George with the jam.
Capable of flat out torching you. Once PG-13 gets into a groove, watch out.
Ball outside. Rozier, the pass to Ball. Takes it inside. Yep, that one goes. Ball's gotten his second bucket.
Allowing any room to operate, you know he's going to be aggressive.
Jackson outside. George with it. Checked by Washington. And George with the jam.
What an athlete Paul George is, leaping up with such ease on those throwdowns.
Ball outside. Pass to McDaniels. Feet out. And it's Charlotte with another.
Whatever they did right in the first half defensively, we're not seeing it now.
Jackson against Ball. George outside. The three is up. The shot no good. So the Hornets will take it the other way. Rozier outside. Right wing. Ball outside. Pass to McDaniels. Rozier with it. George defending. Rozier can't get it to go. For Los Angeles, they've gone 4 of 6 from the floor in this third quarter. George passes to Jackson. Kicks it to George. This for the tie! George with another miss.
Hasn't been able to dial it in from distance. He has just the 1-3, and that was in the first half.
Back to Ball. Pass to Rozier. Clock at 6. They get the rebound. And the layup falls. Now it's a 5-point Hornet lead.
Have to take care of the defensive boards better than that.
Reason why, lack of focus, lack of communication, which led to second chance points.
Now here's George. He's got 15. Now here's Ball. Fires the 3. It's rebounded by Morris. Los Angeles has gone 0-for-2 from outside here in the third. Boy, they need something to go to regain some confidence.
No question. Way too many empty possessions for them.
Ball outside. Connects from downtown. Grant, you played all 4 years at Duke. Nowadays, it's so often one and done. And in a year or two, maybe straight out of high school. Your thoughts on that?
Well, first of all, yes. If you played all 4 years in college nowadays, you're almost penalized for that, which is really weird. But I think when you look back in 2005 and they eliminated the straight out of high school and implemented the one and done rule, teams didn't really have the proper resources to handle the influx of young players. But since that time, the staffs, the player development on and off the court are better suited now to help these kids adjust and transition from high school or 1 year of college right into the NBA. So I see straight out of high school coming back, and I think the league is better prepared for that when it happens.
Yeah, and the G League is a major part of that as well. And so it's Charlotte with it. The Clippers getting their last shot to go. Outside Graham. Drives to the hoop. Great D that time from Rondo.
There is the value of great rim protection without fouling, forcing the miss.
George, no good. Charlotte has gone 2 of 3 from outside so far in the third quarter. Outside Graham from downtown. That shot off the mark. And the Clippers will go the other way with it. George outside. And the jam by George.
His hang time on the rim puts a sweet cherry on top, BA.
It's a close game, and those displays of explosiveness can jumpstart a team. Charlotte again missing. For Los Angeles, they've gone 6 of 13 to open up this second half. Here's Leonard. Washington grabs the miss. Washington's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Zeller high post. And Kawhi Leonard gets a whistle that time. That's his first foul of the game. Biombo, he's checked in for Charlotte. Monk comes in for Rozier. To the wing, right side. 6 on the shot clock. Here's Monk. And there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot 2. And the first one at the line is good. Kennard, he's checked in for the Clippers. He's off on the second. The Clippers trail. Fade away. Rondo's shot is off. Pass to Graham. takes a three. Rebounded by Cousins.
Still trying to shoot his way out of this funk. But if it doesn't come within the flow of the offense, the whole team suffers.
Back to Beverly. And here's Rondo. Graham covering. Rondo's shot is off. Charlotte has gone 2 for 5 from three since halftime. Pass to Monk. Now Biombo. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws. It's going to go on to Marcus Cousins.
Hey, if you can't block it, sending him to the line can be the next best thing.
That one's off. You know, the three-pointer increasing in prominence in recent years. Grant, you averaged less than one long-range attempt per game for your career. So what made you look to attack inside the arc more?
Yeah, B.A., it really is about the evolution of the game. Early in my career in the mid-90s, it was all about getting the high-percentage shot, getting to the rim, posting up, the mid-range game. But as the game has changed and evolved, now it's more about the three-point shot. At the end of my career, that's when I started to shoot more three-pointers as the game was evolving.
Kennard outside. Here's Zubats. And it's slammed in by Zubats.
B.A., I'm not sure he should be flaunting around the rim like that with this game so close.
Oh, it's risky, but it sure did look good. Here's Monk. 7 points in the game. Pass to Biombo. And Biombo slams it home.
Woo! Defensively, you can't afford to let him get to the rim that easily.
Well, that might be why their deficit is what it is right now.
It's a backbreaker for your defense, giving up easy buckets like that.
Now here's Zubats. Checking his numbers, he's put up a little over 9 points a game. To the inside, Zeller. Ooh, here's Zeller, slams it home.
One sign of a great playmaker, hitting his man in stride.
They're searching for a way to score.
Yeah, buckets have been very tough to come by.
Pass to Kennard. Going inside, 5 on the clock. Is Beverly. And it's slammed in by Zubats.
Grabs the board and goes right in for the putback. I love it, B.A.
Yeah, wanting to close the gap. Makes sense to get aggressive on the glass here. Now here's Biombo to the right side. Back to Graham. Pass to Biombo. Shoots over Zubats. Misses off the right iron. Los Angeles has gotten nothing to fall from outside in this third quarter. Beverly with it. And stolen by Graham. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. And it's Monk missing.
He liked to have that one back. That's easy money.
Kennard outside. 12 seconds left in the third quarter. Shot clock at 6. The three. Doesn't go that time. And we've watched 3 so far in this one. It's the Hornets up 6. And don't go away. We'll be back in a few moments. It'll be the fourth quarter of basketball coming up next. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm Assist of the Game.
And I'll tell you what, this was a no-brainer tonight. Take a look at the precision on this feed. Couldn't place it any better.
This is why you preach teamwork. Some of the most spectacular plays are the ones where guys are feeding off one another.
Well, this has been a great contest so far. I imagine the fourth quarter could have more action in store for us. Washington is the four and Zeller at center. Ball is out there with Terry Rozier. And it's McDaniels in at the three spot. So that's the group out there for Charlotte. Here's Ball, following the score by the Clippers. Washington outside. Out to the right wing. Here's Zeller. And he lays it up and in.
With a tough road ahead, they worked hard to get a good shot.
Stolen by Rozier. Ball outside. The three. It's hauled in by the Clippers. George outside. Played it in with a nice touch off the window. George has got 21 points in the game.
And you want him taking good shots at this point in the game. And that one was easy.
And I don't think he expected to get that good of a look. Poor communication defensively.
Now here's Ball. Here's Washington. Hits the trifecta. And the Hornets lead by seven.
They are unconscious from outside. And so far, the defense has had no answer.
You know what? They talked about this at halftime. And they're doing a better job of creating space.
And that one's good. George has gotten four this quarter.
We've seen that more than once today. An effortless basket inside.
Zeller high post. Ball outside. Washington outside. Yes, sir, and it's Ball with the assist that time.
The assist numbers certainly stand out. They've really emphasized ball movement here today.
Pass to Leonard. 4-3. It's rebounded by Charlotte. Ball's got 9 rebounds in the game. Boy, he's getting it done.
What I like, he hasn't stopped competing despite the off night.
Here's Rondo. Battles through traffic and lays it in. Rondo, he's got his first 2 points of the night. To the left side wing. McDaniels from long range. And it's the Clippers with the rebound. George has got 4 rebounds now.
And he almost made them regret defending him so loosely.
Pass to Zeller. Washington outside. Here's Rozier. And he's 6-for-12 after that one.
He's really finding his rhythm here. I mean, smart move to keep feeding him the ball.
Let him decide whether to shoot it, whether to pass it. He's your catalyst right now.
Now here's Leonard. Ooh, nice fadeaway to get it over the top.
An all-NBA first-teamer in 2016, Kawhi can drop points on you from anywhere.
Pass to McDaniels. Let's a floater go. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Opportunity for a 3-point play here.
That's nice work, stopping short of the rim, just laying it over the top.
So both teams changing it up here. A little over 3.5 minutes in the books now in this fourth quarter. Pass to Zubats. Jackson with it. Here's Leonard. That basket is good. Off the assist from Jackson. Jackson's got 6 assists here tonight. Here's Martin. Back to Ball. Now here's Rozier. 3-pointer. It's rebounded by Morris.
Not in rhythm. He had the 2 triples in the first half. None so far in the second.
Charlotte has got 2 of 5 threes to go here in the fourth. Over to the wing. To the middle. Here's Washington. Great D that time from Zubats. The Clippers have gone 6 for 9 here in the fourth quarter. Here's Jackson. Ball with the rebound. Ball's got 11 rebounds in the game. Pass to McDaniels. Rozier outside. 4 on the clock. Tries the spin move. And there's the drive. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
And sends it home with some passion.
I think he's rubbing it in a little bit here. Hang it up there like that. Jackson outside. Pass to Leonard. It's good. And he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A 3-point play opportunity.
One shot.
The free throw drops for Leonard.
You know, when you look at the MVP race each year, most of the candidates were drafted in the top 5, but somehow Kawhi lasted to number 15.
Now here's Rozier. Shoots over George. That's short off the rim.
That was the best he could do. Just fade a little bit, try and get a clean look, but the defense was right on him.
And that one drops. And now it's just a 4-point Charlotte lead. The Hornets shooting 55% since the start of the fourth. Jacks up a 3. It's hauled in by the Clippers. Zubats has got his 16th rebound on the night.
So frustrating when you can't get anything to go down as you're trying to help your team finish the job.
Jackson can't get it to go.
The struggle is real. He's been way off with his shot all evening long.
Rozier can't get it to go. The Clippers have gotten 8 of 13 shots to find the basket in the fourth quarter. Here's Leonard. And he banks in the layup. Leonard's got 11 points in the quarter.
The power, the length, the ability to finish. Leonard dominant in that painted area.
Time called here. The Hornets decide to talk it over.
Looking now for some consistency. Just too many missed shots.
You know, this is a good time to maybe switch up your strategy a little bit. You can't keep doing what you're doing and expect a different result.
All right, time now to present our New Balance Player of the Game, Terry Rozier.
And he really made his presence felt on the inside. Just so active and looking all game long for openings. And he found them by scoring a lot of baskets by slashing to the hoop.
Here's McDaniels. Pass to Rozier. And here's Washington for three. Can't hit that one.
He had more than enough room to hit that. Just couldn't make it happen.
George outside. Here's Leonard. So it'll be two free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting.
And what's interesting, B.A., is that early in his career, you wondered if Marcus Morris would find his way in this league. And as a tweener forward, it really wasn't until year six that he really took off.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Makes it, and the next one could tie it up. And you know, Grant, for a player like Marcus Morris, the game has really pivoted in his direction, I think.
That is so true, B.A., and with shooting has never been more in fashion and more important. So with switchability at a premium, his 6'8" height becomes even more of an asset.
That one drops. He ties it up.
Money from the stripe. He does a great job night in and night out.
Rozier outside. Here's Washington. Oh, he powers right through the defender for the dunk. Draws the foul, too. And he'll go to the line. And it's going to be on Ivica Zubac. And the free throw, no good. Los Angeles has gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the fourth quarter. Here's Jackson. The Hornets pull it in. Here's Martin. To the paint. Washington's shot is good. And now a 4-point Charlotte lead.
Defensively, they've had no answer for him this period, and he continues to stay aggressive.
George outside.
I have to admit, I mean, it's always a tough decision for the ref on the block charge call.
Here's Jackson. Pass to Zubac. Here's Leonard. Five to shoot. Knocks down the long J.
He wants the ball. Has a flair for the dramatic. Unfazed in big situations.
Now here's Washington. Out left to the wing. Rozier outside. Ball, a screen on George. Rozier against George. McDaniels from long range. No luck on that one. And the Clippers will go the other way with it. To take the lead. And there's the play by Leonard inside. Leonard's got 27.
Great anticipation. He has great hands. Kawhi gobbles up second chance opportunities.
George against Rozier. He takes it in. The putback. Paul George pulls it in. The Clippers in the lead. Pass to Leonard. And it's Martin with the rebound. And for Charlotte, they're shooting around 42% as we continue play in the fourth quarter. He goes up. Money.
There is absolutely no fear in his eyes. He loves the moment.
Incredible shot with everything on the line coming through for his team.
There's 48 seconds left in the game. George against Rozier. Washington a screen. On the attack, Rozier.
Count it! All he needed was a little separation. So effective.
Boy, cleared the path, put him in position for a prime-time dunk.
That's a big-time move and a big-time finish.
And the Clippers have possession after the basket by Charlotte. Great positioning on the putback. And the Clippers lead by three.
He really gets in perfect position for the follow. Just a terrific read.
And the Hornets with possession here. It's a three-point game. 2 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. Rozier. Pass to Martin. There's Ball with a three. The three won't fall. And they commit an intentional foul. We'll see another one of those, so they get into the penalty.
Yeah, no, you had to do that. I mean, you can't allow them to dribble out the time.
And that's an intentional foul. He hits the first one, and that gives him a 4-point cushion.
And with Reggie Jackson, it's a testament to his natural talent that he often leaves us wanting a little bit more.
So he gets them both, and it's a 5-point game.
There's the knockout blow. No chance of getting up off the canvas now.
Here's Martin. And a miss there on the triple. So the Clippers win it. Just a gutsy performance on the road.
It really was. When this one was up in the air late, they showed how tough-minded they are as a team.
All right, Allie's ready to go. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Kawhi, a tremendous performance for you. How satisfying is it to control the game the way you did tonight?
It's very satisfying. And I just feel great that my guys have confidence in me out there, and they want me to keep being aggressive on the floor.
Well, you don't give them a lot of reasons not to have confidence in you, and so they will continue to, I'm sure. Thanks, Kawhi.
All right, Allie, thank you. And that about wraps it up. For Allie LaForce, Grant Hill, and Steve Smith, this is Brian Anderson with our 2K Sports crew signing off. We'll see you next time.